G'day guys, welcome to the channel. Today I'm coming to you from District 1 in beautiful downtown Ho Chi Minh City.
Well, this is my first time back for 2.5 years, and to be honest, things haven't really changed much. The traffic is still as crazy as ever. This isn't the peak hour, of course, it's only just after lunchtime, so it's not too bad, but around 5 p.m. it's going to get really congested and chaotic. Okay, we're continuing on with our look at the war history in and around Ho Chi Minh City. And to kick things off, I'm here at Independence Palace. The significance of this place is that when the war ended, this is the final point where the North Vietnamese Army proclaimed victory over the South. According to the information placard that's nearby here, these were the two tanks that actually smashed through the gates on the 30th of April 1975 for the North Vietnamese Army to finally proclaim victory. According to the placard that's in front of this plane, an aircraft very similar to this was basically stolen by a communist pilot who then used it to bomb the palace in April 1975. All right, here I am inside Independence Palace, a refurbished one, and to do the tour through here, or walk through, costs 65,000 kip. You can pay an additional amount, I think it's around about 80,000, to get a audio device to give you a tour, which I guess a lot of helpful information. Just depends if you actually want to pay that much. Alright, well, what we're looking at here is a billboard inside the palace. That's how it looked back in the early 70s before it got bombed. And the photo above it is how it appears now after it was rebuilt. This is the state banquet room, which was used back in the day. Early 70s, I guess, because it's got that look about it, it's a bit retro. All right, I'm at the top of the Independence Palace, looking down on the gates that were smashed down when the North Vietnamese Army came through to declare final victory on the 30th of April 1975. Okay, this is the type of chopper that was used by the South Vietnamese and US forces. I guess they called it a Huey. And in the foreground there, those two red circles were the locations where the bombs that were dropped by the Vietnamese pilot. Well, that's where the bombs landed. Good morning guys, welcome back to the video. This morning I'm at one of these Vietnamese historical sites from the Vietnam War, and this place is called Binh Duoc, and it's about 70 kilometers from Ho Chi Minh City. The primary attraction of this place is a network of underground tunnels used by the Viet Cong during their war against the US forces. Alright, we've completed our look at the war museum over there. We're now heading down to the tunnels area.
Connect it with a big bamboo pile like that. From here, go inside had a tunnel, and yes, the air.
All right, what we're looking at here is the air ventilation point for the tunnels.
Because, you know.
All right, what we've got here is the entrance to one of the tunnels, the VC tunnels. Apparently they're quite narrow, but I'm going to head down and see if I can squeeze through there. All right, this is one of the tour guides, and we're down underground in the VC tunnels. And this is one of the tourists that's coming down here with me. As you can see, it's fairly cramped.
Yeah.
Okay, one of the guides here is climbing into a manhole, which was the sizes for the VC-sized soldier. And now he's going to show us how he, when they go down, they cover the hole back up.
No Americans will fit in here.
You want to move?
Go, three.
All right, we've got one of the tour group here that's gone from one end of the 10-meter tunnel to the other, and he's climbing himself out.
Can I find the way?
Wow.
Well done.
For the hospital?
All right, what we're looking at here now is a bunker, and the entrance is a bit larger.
Oh yeah, we have the bunker here, and from guys, continuing on with my video about the historical war sites in and around Saigon. This morning, I'm on my way to a location called the Biosphere, also known as Monkey Island, and part of the trip involves going across this river here on a ferry. I've been on the road for about 45 minutes, and once we get to the other side, it'll be around about another 45 minutes before we actually get to the site. Okay, we'll see you over there. Okay, we've finally arrived at the Kangeo Biosphere, otherwise known as Monkey Island. It was quite a long drive to get here. Just over 2 hours from the hotel, and what we're going to do is have a look at a couple of interesting spots before we head to the historical VC camp. Okay, it's quite busy today. Maybe the wrong day to come on a Saturday, and with it being the weekend, it's quite a few people here, mainly local tourists. All right, one of the things they do on the way to the historical village is stop and feed the monkeys with peanuts.
Hello? When you finish the pizza and you want more to fish the monkey, just tell me and we'll give you more.
According to the guide, this very extensive mangrove area, something like 36,000 hectares, and apparently also a UNESCO site now. All right, we're on the move again. Next stop is the crocodile pond. All right, here we are at the crocodile enclosure, and there are a few crocs about. They're looking a bit lazy at the moment, probably enjoying the sun there. This bloke here has got his mouth open, he's waiting for a feed. Actually, if you want to pay a bit of extra money, you can get a little fishing rod with some bait on it and feed the crocs. These three here don't look too interested in the bait they're being offered. They're actually small eels with their heads chopped off. Right, that fellow's hooked onto one. There we go, the big fella's got his mouth open. All right, after all the fun and excitement of the monkeys and the crocodiles, we're now heading to the VC historical camp. It's about a 1 kilometer walk there. Okay, we're deep inside the mangrove area now. We're about 1 kilometer from the actual start point where the monkeys were, and we're heading towards the historical camp. Okay, the trail now is bordered walkways through the mangrove area and right through to the camp, I believe. Now we've arrived at the VC historical camp, and according to my guide, this camp was first established way back in the late 1960s. It's basically a reenactment of life in the mangroves or mangrove swamps for the VC forces, and there's mannequins there to depict daily life. Oh, it was a nightmare, Lord, it was so true. They told me don't go.